hand over to Mr. Awasthi, who is going to talk about, so I'll just give you an introduction to his talk. He is going to talk about a tool called Firebug. So during the last 5-day workshop, there were many questions on what are cookies and how are they used and how can you see them and where are they stored and you know, do you have session information in them, how is authentication done, and so on and so forth. I thought these were substantially important issues that we needed a tool so that in the lab you can go and see, and then later on when you go to your class you can actually show it to your students. You can show Firebug, which is an extension to Firefox, and you can inspect all of these things. You can look at the different cookies that are stored on your machine, how many different cookies from the Google site or from the Microsoft site or from the IITB site, etc., etc. Make some sense of the cookies, see whether these cookies are encrypted or encoded in some way using Base64 encoding. When you send your username and password to your LDAP server in your college or in your university, is it encoded in some way? What is Base64 encoding? Can I hack into your password and get it out from there, etc., etc., etc.? So there are tens of questions that could be asked on this, and the lab tomorrow will actually address them. The lab today is on Wireshark. The lab tomorrow is on Firebug and also the beginnings of DBWA. So Abhishek Awasthi is over here to tell you how to use this tool called Firebug, which is an extension to Firefox, how to use it and what all information you can get from this very interesting tool.
I will be presenting about Firebug, which is an extension of Mozilla Firefox browser. So using it, we can do many things like debugging and other basic security analysis like cookie analysis and network traffic analysis, and some headers we can check what is going, like what cookies are going and what cookies are coming from the server side. So let's start with installing the Firebug, how to install it. So we just need to use Google search engine and just type Firebug Mozilla add-on. Actually it is for Mozilla Firefox, so we need to mention it, Mozilla add-on. So it is showing these links, these results. So the first link is our Firebug link. So this is the page where you can get this plugin. So let's try to install it. Here it is a button. This is add to Firefox. We just need to press it. Now we can see it is being downloaded. After downloading, it is asking for installation. So we just need to click this button, install now. And here we can see it is successfully installed. So before going further, actually, as we know, HTTP protocol is a stateless protocol. So if a web application want to know about the user to authenticate or identify a user, so it needs some kind of approaches, some kind of methods to track the user, to identify the user or authenticate the user. So for this, there are some approaches. I will be covering 3 approaches out of them. So first one is basic access authentication. Second one is using hidden fields. Third one is using cookies. So let's start with basic access authentication. So in basic access authentication, when we need it, like if I want to share a file with particular specific number of users, like the participants which are involved in this workshop, so I would like to get some kind of information from the user which is trying to access it. Like I can provide them some kind of username, passwords, so that I can, that web application can get to know that authenticated user is accessing the file, not everybody else. So let's check it, one example for that. Okay, first of all, before going to that, we need to know how to start Firebug. It is just a simple process. We just need to press the function key F12. It will open this kind of panel below the page. So this is our Firebug. I will explain all these tabs which are there. Like this first tab, this is written as cookies. So this is all about cookies. I will be covering this cookie further. And so let's, as we have installed, just installed this Firebug tool. So first we need to enable this panel. This is a cookie panel. So we need to enable it. Just after pressing the enable button, it is being enabled. So we can see some data here. I will explain it later what is it. So let's go to other tab. This is net tab. We also need to enable this tab also. So this net tab is all about seeing the traffic between the browser and the server, communication between the browser and the server. Next it, DOM, document object model. Here we can see the whole document object model of the website, the page. And then it is script tab, which is all about JavaScript used by that website or that web page. So we need to enable this panel also. Then we will switch to CSS. It is all about style sheet, styling of that web page. Then HTML of that web page. This and this next panel is of console. Here we can use it as kind of terminal. We provide some JavaScript code here and can run it here on the fly. So we need to enable it also. So these are some tabs which are available on Firebug. Okay, now we will go to basic access authentication, like just I talked about. So I am using a URL of IITB, which asks for username and password whenever we try to access it. So it is asking for username and password, so that only students of IITB can access it. So I will try a dummy username and password, which is my name, just Abhishek. So I just entered a dummy username and password which was not correct, so it is not authenticating me. So we don't need to concern about that. We just need to check what is happening behind the scene. So we will open this net tab using Firebug, and we will check this first head, this information, what is happening behind. Okay, I will enlarge this so that we can see it easily. Okay, so here we can see there are some kind of headers. This is response header, and there are some data like connection, content length, and like that. And this is request header. So as we can see in request header, there is a authorization, this one. So this authorization is the main thing. It is containing our username and password we just entered in some encoded form. And it actually uses base64 encoding. So we will check, are we correct? So let's try to decode it. I will first copy this. We need some kind of base64 decoder. So we can use some online tool for that. So I am searching for that on Google. Base64 online decoder. So we can use this first link. It is providing an online tool for decoding. We can decode any base64 string. So it will provide us the plain text data corresponding to that encoded string. So here I am copying that data, that encoded data we have just seen there. Let's recheck it, the data is same or not. So this was the data, Y, W, J, O, A, like that. So this is the same string. I'm going to decode it. Just pressing the decode button. So now we can see it has been decoded as this Abhishek, then colon, then Abhishek. Actually, it was containing username and password separated by a colon. So I have provided, as I provided that my name Abhishek as username as well as password. So it is this Abhishek colon Abhishek. So it means we have successfully decoded it, and it was actually a base64 encoding. So we can verify using this method. So that was about base64 encoded basic access authentication. Now we will switch to hidden fields based authentication methods or identification method. So I am going to demonstrate URL using a URL like this is csc.iitb.ac.in. So first we want to know how to see hidden fields. So we cannot see them like in using this browser UI. So we need to go into the HTML. So we will use Firebug for that. As we can see here, there are only two fields we can able to see. We are able to see like username and password. So we will get into HTML using Firebug. This is a HTML tab. We just need to press it. Now we need to search for hidden fields. So let's use the search tab, search field. So I will type here hidden so that I can identify the hidden fields. Now here we can see this is HTML data of the web page. So we can see here this is showing input type equals to hidden. It means this is a hidden field which is containing some data, but it is not visible to normal users. There are two like such hidden fields. So this is containing some kind of data which will be used by website, web application to authenticate or identify the user. But a normal user can see only two fields are there, username and password. But actually behind the scene there are more than two fields. So let's try to check when we click this kind of form which is containing some hidden data. So how the data is traveling, what are the other parameters or values are going to the server side. So there is another approach, like if you want to see the HTML code of a particular field or a division on that page, view page, so we just need to click, right click on that, like we just need to right click here and it will show the Firebug option to see the HTML data of that input field. So here at the last menu option is inspect element with Firebug. So I will just press it. And now it is showing the HTML tag, HTML data of that input field. So as we can see input and then ID, then type equals to text like that. Okay, but we are more concerned about hidden fields, not the normal fields. So we will see those hidden fields which are available there behind the scene. So like this, there are around 3 and even 6 hidden fields are there. Which are containing some value and having some name. Like this is action having a action name, then time zone and like that, which this data will be used by the web application and it was inserted by the web application so that it can identify or authenticate the user. So we will see another field which is password, which is visible to a normal user. This is named as underscore pass. So now we will submit this form using some dummy username and password. It is same as my name Abhishek, and we will click the login button. So for if we see it normally, so the data which is going to the server side should contain only two data, username and password, but it is containing some hidden fields also. So the actual data which is going to the server side is containing more than two fields. Let's check it out. We will go to the net tab of Firebug and we'll go to the post request of that header to see what data is going to the server side. And we will press that post tab. It is showing these many fields are going to the server side. But for now, normal user, there were only two fields, username and password. But it is actually sending around eight fields, like first is action, then password, task, time zone, token, URL, like that. So as we can see, I had entered this password as Abhishek and username as Abhishek. So we can see that data. So this is a token, some kind of identification, random string used by verification. So let's check it out whether it is the same string or not. So we will just verify it. This is the username I had entered. So let's verify that token which was in a hidden field. This was the token. And let's check the HTML data. So this was the input field which was containing that token value. This is 91C5FB17, like that. And here in HTML form it is the same 91C5FB1, like that. So using this, the verification is trying to authenticate that the valid or legitimate form has been submitted by the client, by the user. So this was the hidden fields. Using this, our verification can also identify or authenticate the users. So we have just completed two approaches. First was basic access authentication, which was using base64 encoding for sending username and password. Then second one was hidden fields, and now we will cover the third one is cookies. Cookie is a very important term, so let's talk about cookie. What is actually a cookie? Cookie is nothing, just a key value pair which has been which is used by verifications and which it is stored by verification on the user side, on the user's browser, so that it can know whether it is user, the user is visiting their site first time or second or third time, and based on that they can provide some good interactive services and some user friendly services also. So let's check it out. We will try to visit a site first time. So we need to check when we are visiting a website first time, then what's happening behind the scene, and when we are visiting the same site again, then what is happening. Let's visit this URL, www.eduhat.com, eduhat.com. So we can see using the Firebug in the cookie tab, there are some name and value. These are the key and value pair of cookie. These name are containing the parameters or identifier for that cookie, and this value field is containing the value of particular cookie. And these are some other fields I will talk about later. So we will go into the net tab to view what is happening behind the scene when we are visiting this website first time. So these are request and response headers, and in this response header we can see a set cookie, and which is containing some identifier, then equal sign, then some value. So this identifier is the key for that cookie, and the right hand side of the equal sign is containing the value of that cookie. So this is request header. As we can see, there is no cookie information in the request header. So what is happening actually when we are visiting this site first time? So verification come to know that some new user is visiting their site. So they need to store some cookie to that user's browser so that they can track or they can identify when that particular user visits the their site next time. So in request field there was no cookie value because we are visiting this site first time. But in the response header there is a set cookie field which is trying to store the cookie in user's browser first time. So let's go further. This is request header which was not containing any cookie information. So let's try to enlarge it so that we can view it clearly. Request and response headers are there, and some header fields, accept and like importing language, host, like that, user agent, Mozilla, then response headers, there are many fields. So we are more concerned about cookie things. So this is set cookie which is storing a new cookie. So let's try to visit this site again. So now we are not a new user for that site. Now we are visiting the site again, so it should identify us. So let's see. We'll again use the net tab of Firebug and we will check out. So we can see response headers and request headers. So now we will check what are the changes compared to the last widget. So now we can see this request header is also containing cookie information, and last time it was not there. So now what is happening is when we visited it first time, the website first time, so it stored some cookie information in our browsers, in our browser. So now when we are visiting this website second time, so the browser is sending the cookie information to the web server so that web application can identify me as I am a second time visitor, not a first time visitor. So this request header is also containing cookie information. This is the same value which was stored earlier. As we can see, that one was also 1F8, like that. Now we will check the response header. Now it is not containing any set cookie data because it has already stored the cookie. It can add some more cookies, but it is not using at the time. So now we will check about what are other fields are available there in the cookie tab of Firebug. So we will go one by one. First one is name, which is containing the identifier for cookie, to identify a cookie. This is name of the cookie, then value of that cookie corresponding to that cookie. then domain of that, which website is storing that particular cookie, then raw size of that cookie, then path and that domain, then expires. It is very important to know about it. So we can see there are two type of, one is session and one is containing some expiration date. So actually cookies are of some many types. So there are basically two types. One is session cookie and second one is persistent cookie or tracking cookie. Session cookies, it is stored for a particular time, means whenever we are closing the browser, session cookies will be deleted. But persistent cookie or tracking cookie should be there even after closing the browser, and the expiry date of that persistent cookie can be defined using this expiration date. Like this is containing 7/8/2016, so it is containing more 2 years for expiration date. So even after we close this browser, it will persist here, so that it can track our activity and it can identify us next time. So persistent cookie, if we talk about real time, so we can take an example of e-commerce sites. When we visit any e-commerce site, then what we find is, like, we are exploring some laptops or mobiles. So I checked some particular laptop models this time, and when I'm going to visit that particular site second time, then it will be suggesting me that you have visited or seen these models of this particular laptop. How it is happening? Actually, behind the scene, it is using the cookie, these persistent cookie which are there in our browser even after closing the browser. So using those cookie, that website is able to detect that I am the particular user which was visiting these models, laptop models or mobile. So this way, this persistent cookie are very useful for any site. So now we will talk about this HTTP only. So actually, HTTP only cookie, there is an advantage is that like in some kind of attacks like XSS attacks, cross-site scripting attacks, it uses JavaScript functions to fetch out the cookies so that it can use it like in session hijacking and other things. So using this HTTP only, we can restrict that no JavaScript function will be able to access these kind of cookies. So this is a security, good security method approach. And another one is security field. So we will see another site so that we can get an and this is the value of that particular cookie. So see the security field. To know about more the security field, we will visit another site, because this site is not containing any secure cookie. So these were the expiration date and session, difference between the session cookies and persistent cookie as we saw. This was the HTTP only. So now we will visit another site like flipkart.com. So to try to see the secure cookies. So here we can see in security field, there is a secure keyword is used. So it is actually identifying, it is actually mentioning that this kind of cookie, whenever it will be sent to the server side, it will be encrypted so that it cannot be stolen or like that. So this is keyword secure. That was all about cookies. So we have completed today three approaches. One was basic access authentication using base64 encoding. Second one was hidden fields, and third one was cookies. So with this, I would like to thank you.